Why don't we explore Venus if it is much closer to Earth than Mars? What is the closest planet to Earth? No, it's not Mars. Although Mars is a famous planet, the title of the closest planet does not belong to it. If we talk about distances, Venus is the closest planet to the Earth, although on average Mercury spends more time near the Earth than Venus. How is this possible? And if Venus is the closest planet to Earth, why aren't there so many missions to explore it? Let's go. We live in a time when space exploration is seriously thinking about reaching Mars in the coming years. Even the wealthiest man in the world, Elon Musk, has repeated ad nauseum his goal of wearing the first generation of humans to the red planet as soon as possible. Currently, this goal is increasingly realistic, and some space agencies such as NASA already have programs that seek to take the first step to colonize Mars. Even so, faced with this panorama, it is valid to ask ourselves, why is this obsession with visiting the red planet and on another like Venus, which is much closer to Earth? First, why did we say Mercury is the closest planet to Earth? Aren't Mercury, Venus, and Earth supposed to be in the order of closeness to the Sun? In that case, Mercury should be much farther away than Venus, right? The thing is that since Mercury spins very fast on average, it spends more time close to the Earth than Venus, which spins slower, and therefore spends less time away from the Earth. But that's just on paper. In practice, it's completely different. If we talk about actual space travel, Venus is closer than Mercury, since the distance between Earth and Venus is shorter than the distance between Earth and Mercury. So saying that Venus is closer is not a mistake. But if we look at it from that point of view, Mercury is even farther away than Mars, since to reach Mercury, spacecraft must accelerate using gravitational assistance for years, while to reach Mars, we can take advantage of the approach gaps between Mars and Earth every 26 months and arrive in less than a year. So, what is the closest planet to the Earth? Leave us your comment if you would like us to make a video answering this question. Getting back to Venus, for centuries it would have been inconceivable that Venus stopped being so perceived by the scientific community as in the modern era. In the 18th century, Venus was the main reason astronomers and scientists around the world organized themselves to discover the solar system's mysteries. When humanity could finally take the leap and leave the planet with spaceships, the first place it reached was Venus. It was our first successful planetary encounter beyond Earth, and the first planet on which humans placed their technology. Venus and Earth are practically twins. They are similar in size, density, gravity, and physical composition. Both are in our star's habitable zone and are relatively close to each other. And yet, at some point in the solar system's history, Earth became a cosmic paradise for life as we know it, and Venus became a hostile, scorching hell where no form of life can exist. Why? In previous videos like this one, where we explained how much you would weigh on each planet in the solar system, we mentioned the harsh conditions of the planet Venus. If a spacecraft wanted to land on the surface of Venus, it would first have to deal with the acidic, toxic, cloud-filled atmosphere that corrodes metal and degrades any electrical components. Once on the surface, visitors would encounter average temperatures of 430 degrees Celsius, a heat that would melt any spacesuit. To all this, dense clouds are added that are present all the time and cover the rays of light, so the sky is orange, full of storms, lightning, and acid rain that melts everything it touches. Do not forget that Venus suffers from a lasting greenhouse effect, so extreme temperatures are constant and do not vary according to the place. That means winter doesn't exist on this planet, so there's no escape from the extreme heat. As if this weren't enough, the atmospheric pressure on Venus is about 90 bars, equivalent to being submerged 1 kilometer at the bottom of the sea. As you can imagine, no human or living being could survive in such extreme conditions. Or that is what we believe. Twins separated at birth. Years ago, the Kepler Space Telescope discovered more than 3,000 planets around other stars, many of which are orbiting inhabitable zones where water could be stable on the surface. These Earth 2.0s are located hundreds of thousands of light years away and are difficult to study with modern technology, since we barely receive minor points of light. Conveniently, there is an Earth 2.0 right next to ours. It's Venus. Studies on the atmosphere of the second closest planet to the Sun have shown that there is a high probability that in the remote past of the history of Venus, this was a planet covered with water like Earth. It is even likely that it had oceans and perhaps also vast forests full of life. Of course, there's no way to prove this at the moment. Still, by understanding the history of Venus, we will also better understand the history of Earth and the nature of potentially habitable exoplanets. Also, while scientists and policymakers grapple with climate change, they can look at Venus, because for Venus's atmosphere to have gone from being a paradise like Earth to the hell it is today, something extraordinary had to have happened. According to experts such as Bob Grimm, director of the Department of Space Studies at the Southwest Research Institute, the Earth will not become Venus, since that requires amounts of carbon dioxide that our planet does not possess. Still, Venus has many lessons about how the Earth's climate can evolve in the future, and a better understanding of these processes will help us be prepared for climate changes in the next few years. With so much to learn on a planet close to Earth, anyone would wonder why NASA stopped exploring Venus. Why is it that, being such a vital planet, not so much effort is made to explore it? Money. On one hand, there is not enough money. NASA receives half of 1% of the US federal budget for its space exploration projects and missions, and only a fraction of that money goes to planetary science. Second, it is much easier to explore our other neighbor, Mars, than to study Venus for many reasons. Mars is farther away than Venus, but also moves slower, so it's easier for our spacecrafts to catch up, even if it takes a long time. On the contrary, Venus is closer to the Sun, which means that it moves much faster. Because of this, it is also necessary for our ships to acquire very high speeds that are only possible with gravitational assistance. Mars does not melt lead. Currently, the rovers sent to the Red Planet are still in operation, although their life periods were initially only a couple of years. Now they have useful lives measured in decades, thanks to the fact that Mars is not so hostile to technology. It seems that it will also be friendly with humans when we visit it. In contrast, any robotic mission to the surface of Venus will be extremely short and highly risky. In fact, the record of the operation of the spacecraft on the surface of Venus is 2 hours and was reached by the Venera 13 exploration probe launched by the Soviet Union in 1981. It is understandable that NASA is not willing to carry out a million-dollar mission just to obtain data for 2 hours. In addition, Mars has a romantic appeal that Venus will never have. Humans will one day walk on Mars and perhaps settle there in the coming years. This dream motivates us to continue researching and exploring the Red Planet that will possibly be the second home of the human race in the future. On the contrary, it is unimaginable to think that one day humans can set foot on the surface of Venus. Venus, Earth, and Mars are three very similar planets. All three are in the habitable zone, but only Earth has all the conditions to have living beings and water in a liquid state. Studying both planets helps us not only better understand their history, but also helps us better understand our planet. Life, the engine of exploration. One of the biggest reasons space agencies worldwide don't invest in exploring Venus is the human race's obsessive approach to proving that we are not alone in the universe, that is, to find evidence of extraterrestrial life. The question of whether we are alone in the universe is too tempting for any space agency to resist. That's why so many rovers have been sent to Mars, to determine habitability and, with the Mars 2020 rover, to find habitable zones. This is why telescopes look for exoplanets in habitable zones, solar systems with optimal conditions to host liquid water, and signals that may come from an intelligent extraterrestrial civilization. All our joint efforts aimed at the same goal, to find something, whatever can give us hope that we are not the only ones in this vast universe. Until now, one of the main goals of missions to Mars has long been to find water, because where there's water, there can be life. At least life as we know it, carbon-based and oxygen-dependent. We cannot look for other types of life forms since life on Earth is the only form of life we know in the entire universe. In this ongoing search for life, space agencies have set their eyes on Mars and the moons of the gas giants Jupiter and Saturn, especially on those moons with large reserves of frozen water. One of them is Europa, Jupiter's moon, and Enceladus, Saturn's moon, frozen worlds that could have oceans beneath their thick ice sheets. This relentless search for extraterrestrial life makes Venus unattractive for exploration. At the beginning of the history of the solar system, it was thought that Venus had an ocean on its surface. Scientists came to this conclusion since asteroids and comets were the ones that brought water to Earth for the first time. And also these were the ones that gave us the essential components of life, amino acids and their precursors. If this happened on Earth, it most likely also happened on the other solar system planets, including Venus. Then could life on Venus have evolved during that time? Earth has been habitable for about 3.9 billion years. Mars was habitable for about 500 million years. Jupiter's moon Europa could be inhabited at this time. Sadly, everything indicates that Venus cannot have a life, because it no longer has the conditions it had in the past. Because of that, it has not been the protagonist of as many space exploration missions as other planets. A new light for Venus fans. NASA recently announced two new missions to our closest neighbor in the solar system, Venus. The main objective of these new missions is to understand how this planet transformed into a hellish world, despite having characteristics similar to Earth. The two missions were selected within the framework of the ninth round of competitions of NASA's Discovery Program, which in 2019 launched a new call for proposals, and since 1992, has promoted the development of more than 20 space exploration missions and instruments that aim to understand the evolution of the solar system. Both missions to Venus will receive initial funding of $500 million each for their development and will be launched between 2028 and 2030. The missions selected for the exploration of Venus were Da Vinci Plus, research of Venus in deep atmosphere of noble gases, chemistry and imaging. The Da Vinci Plus mission will measure the composition of Venus's atmosphere to understand how it formed and evolved and determine whether the planet ever had an ocean. The mission consists of a descending sphere that will plunge through the planet's thick atmosphere, making precise measurements of noble gases and other elements to understand why Venus's atmosphere is a runaway greenhouse compared to Earth's. And the second mission is Veritas. Emissivity, radio science, INSAR, topography, and spectroscopy of Venus. Veritas will map the surface of Venus to assess the planet's geological history and understand why it developed so differently from Earth. Veritas will orbit Venus to map out the surface elevations of nearly the entire planet to create 3D reconstructions of the topography and confirm whether processes such as plate tectonics and volcanism are still active on Venus. These new missions will be in charge of revealing the secrets of Venus that until now had remained hidden and giving us information about how likely it is that there are living organisms in the form of bacteria in its clouds. Would you like us to make a video telling more details about these future missions to Venus? Let us know your opinion with your valuable comment.